We've calculated solution concentrations. These problems now are just a little bit different. We'll be talking about solution preparation. Here's a typical problem. How would you prepare 500 milliliters of a 0.250 molar sodium chloride solution? So in other words, in the laboratory, we'd have a sample of sodium chloride. We'd really be interested in how many grams do we weigh out, and then we're going to dilute it up to 500 milliliters. So we're after grams. You remember the formula for molarity is moles of solute over liters of solution. We're given this number. We have 0.250 moles per liter. And we could probably work this pretty easily using the formula for molarity and solve for grams. I'd like to encourage you, though, to use the factor unit method. If it becomes a habit, you'll get stronger and stronger in your use of the factor unit method. Here's what we're given, and here's what we're after. We'd like to know grams of sodium chloride that we need to weigh out. We want the unit grams over there in the answer, we need the units grams here in the numerator. We'll be canceling moles. So at this point, we have grams per liter. And this really isn't quite a factor, but if we multiply now by the volume that we've been given in liters, liters are going to cancel liters, and we have the units grams. So I haven't thought about Avogadro's number and whether I multiply or divide or whatever. I've simply set up the problem so that the unit comes out right. Then the number will come out right. Let's look at the numbers. Here's what we're given, 0.250 moles per liter. We need grams per mole. Well, we know in one mole, there's the molecular weight in grams of sodium chloride. Looking it up in the periodic table, it's 58.5. The number of liters, well, I took a little shortcut. We had 500 milliliters. We know that's a half a liter. And if we multiply this out then, we get the units grams, which is what we're after. And let's just approximate for a second. The answer that I came up with was 7.31 grams. Let's see if that makes sense. Well, here is about one-fourth, exactly one-fourth. One-fourth times 60 would be about 15. And 15 times a half, well, that'd be about 7.5. So our number's ballpark. And that's a way of checking up on your calculator, making sure that you push the right buttons. This answer, 7.31 grams, we'd need to do one more thing with it. We need to describe how we'd make that solution. We'd go to the balance, we'd weigh out this amount of sodium chloride, and then we'd dilute it up to 500 milliliters. An incorrect way of making that solution would be to take this amount of sodium chloride and add 500 milliliters of water to it. Why would that be wrong? Well, we'd have more than 500 in total volume at that point, because the sodium chloride is going to take up a certain volume. So we always dilute until we reach the final volume. There's another way that we can prepare solutions, and let's look at that way now. Sometimes we're interested in making solutions where liquids are involved. For example, hydrochloric acid is always in liquid form. And there are other times when we repeatedly make a solution, and it would just be great if we had a stock solution sitting on a shelf, a concentrated solution, and we could measure out a certain volume that we need and then dilute that up to our desired volume. It's a little faster than going to a balance and each time weighing out a certain amount of solid and diluting up to a final volume. So it's pretty typical to work with these stock solutions. And we have a formula for dilutions. It's CV is equal to CV. The initial conditions are equal to the final conditions. In other words, the concentration times volume that you have initially is equal to the concentration and volume that you have when you finish the dilution. Here's a typical problem. Describe how to prepare 200 milliliters of a 1 molar hydrochloric acid solution from a solution of 12 molar hydrochloric acid. Well, let's let this 12 molar be our initial concentration, and we're simply going to substitute into the formula. The formula is our roadmap for working the problem. And this initial volume, we need to solve for that. And we're going to make a solution which is 1 molar in concentration, and we need 200 milliliters of it. The one thing that you have to watch out for when you use this formula, CV equals CV, is that we have the same units on the left and on the right. So here we have molarity, on the right we have molarity. Here I have milliliters, that means that the initial volume will be expressed in milliliters. Well, with this equation, we'd like to solve for V sub I. That means that we want all the numbers on the right-hand side so that we can evaluate that term. If I divide the left-hand side by 12 molar, it would cancel. But if whatever we do to this side, we have to do to that side, so we'll divide by 12 molar. And when we do so, we get 16.6 milliliters. With two significant figures right here, we need two significant figures in the answer. And with that 17 milliliters then, what we do is dilute up to a final volume of 200 milliliters, and we'd have the desired solution.